I should like to give the floor to the President of the International Council for Science, Professor Katrin Bishanak.
Sua Excellenza Presidente della Repubblica Italiana, Mrs. Minister of Education, University and Research, President of Consiglio Nazionale di Ricerca, Mrs. Deputy Director General of Food Agriculture Organization, dear ICSU members and partners, ladies and gentlemen. It is my honor to welcome you to the 30th General Assembly of the International Council for Science, ICSU, one of the oldest non-governmental organizations. Following on from Rio de Janeiro, Suzhou, and Maputo, the ICSU family and friends are coming together again in a wonderful city, Roma. Roma, where the Secretariat of ICSU was located a long time ago before moving to Paris. It is great to see that so many of you have made the time in your busy schedules to travel from all parts of the world to spend a week considering how we can work together and deliver ICSU's mission, universality of science for the benefit of society. The world is changing, and rapidly so. Some of the change is potentially good, the Jasmine Revolution in Tunisia and similar events in other Arab countries are surely a cause for optimism, even if the final outcomes remain uncertain. At the same time, the global economic crisis is seriously affecting many countries. Many millions of people are still living in poverty. And the drought in Somalia is described by the United Nations as the worst humanitarian crisis. These massive social changes are occurring in the midst of equally disruptive changes in the environment, a warming climate, and the loss of biodiversity. What will be the legacy that we leave behind for future generations? What is the role of science in shaping this legacy? I will not pretend that ICSU has all the answers, nor even that the combined forces of all the organizations represented in this room have the answer. But I do remain that we have an important role to play in meeting the challenges that lie ahead over the next decades. In this context, ICSU's strategy and programs for the next 6 years will be debated at this assembly, represent a potentially important contribution to the global scientific effort. Whether this potential is realized depends on the extent to which ICSU members and partners, that is to say, all of you, buy into this effort. This is what the next 3 days is really about. 6 years ago in Suzhou, the Assembly approved the launch of the International Polar Year 2007-2008, which turned out to be the largest collaborative research and education program ever undertaken in the polar regions. It brought together tens of thousands of scientists and educators from more than 60 countries and produced critical new insights into the declining state of the poles and their role in regulating the Earth system. The scientific outcomes of from IPY are still accumulating, and the policy implication will be considered by the international community in Montreal in 2012. IPY is a good illustration of what ICSU working with intergovernmental partners, and in this case it's WMO, and its global members' networks can achieve in a relatively short time span. At this assembly, you will hear of the progress that has been made in implementing other global initiatives in disaster risk, ecosystem change, and access to data. You will be asked to make important decisions on proposals for new initiatives on urban well-being and global sustainability. Global sustainability in particular has very important implications for the restructuring and expansion of ICSU's successful programs on global environmental change. It represents a further step in integrating natural sciences, technologies, and social sciences and humanities to provide solutions for the global challenges facing us all. These global challenges will be focused on the United Nations Conference on the Sustainable Development in Rio 2012. You will be asked to endorse ICSU's role in representing the global science community in Rio, in ensuring that science is part of the discussion, in ensuring that information and solutions coming from science and technologies are central to the policy agenda. In these uncertain times, the universality of science, that means construction of a global science community on the basis of equity and non-discrimination, can provide an example for the societies. It is not surprising that many countries are promoting science diplomacy as a way of overcoming economic and political barriers and enabling nations to work together. The principle of universality of science is a bedrock of ICSU, and you will be asked at this assembly to make an important decision on the rewarding of this principle. You will be asked to make explicit the balance between freedom and responsibilities in practice of science. One of the most important decisions concerning ICSU structure was the establishment of ICSU regional offices following a decision of this assembly in Rio 2002. The outcomes of the first independent reviews of the three offices for Africa, Latin America, and Asia will be reported to the Assembly. They have a key role implementing the new initiative described in the new ICSU strategic plan and in ensuring that less developed countries have a strong voice in global science. As the jasmine spring turns hopefully to summer, we need to look to establish better links with the Middle East and North Africa. We have a busy agenda ahead of us for the next 3 days. Many of you have been involved in associated meetings that have been taking place over the past week and member forums that took place earlier today. I hope that this turn out of the prelude of an historical 30th ICSU General Assembly in this historic and beautiful city. My personal view is that the best meetings are those where I learn something new, meet interesting people, and go away feeling that I have contributed even very little to something positive. With those criteria in mind, I wish all of us a good assembly. Thank you again for taking the time to be here.